Thanks for joining us at NewsSentinel.com. I'm Tom Davis, sports editor with the New Sentinel, joined by New Sentinel columnist Reggie Hayes and Colts beat writer. And Reggie, this Saturday, the Colts take on the Redskins in a really interesting matchup, particularly because of the first two draft picks in last April's draft, and Andrew Luck and Robert Griffin III. But there's other components to this game as the Colts have tried to progress through a new coaching staff, new era, new players, and all of that in training camp. What do they really need to focus on this week as far as an area of improvement?
Well, I think what you're going to look at this week is more improvement from the running game. We saw some explosiveness from rookie Vic Ballard against the Steelers. Donald Brown is the number one. Ballard is really pushed to be the number two. Mawelde Moore and DeLon Carter have been out with injuries. They may or may not be back this Saturday. If they're back, they'll get some time because they're also pushing for that spot. So the run game, I think we're going to look at seeing some improvement there. Wide receiver, Donnie Avery is expected to play this week. He was acquired in the offseason as a veteran speedster, but he's been out with a thigh injury, so this is his first time to get in the field, and I think that that's going to be a key for him to get out there with Austin Collie now questionable with his concussion.
Right.
Those two areas on offense, and on defense, we're still looking to see where the Colts are going to develop at the secondary. Who's going to take that spot at corner opposite of Jerrod Powers?
Now, back on the offensive end, I think it was, I read something that it was really interesting. Kobe Fleener was the high draft pick at the tight end spot, but there's been other tight ends that have really kind of overshadowed him so far in camp.
Well, the number three pick, Dwayne Allen, has been a great job. I think Fleener had a good game against the Steelers. I think that was, he looked the best that he's looked so far. Obviously only two games, but I mean, he looked much better in this second game. I think Dwayne Allen has just come on. He is just, he is such a powerful body and such a big guy that if you can get him in certain situations, it's very difficult to bring down.
Right.
And he's done a nice job. So both of them have done well. I think Fleener has been progressively getting better. And I think both of them will be key contributors this year immediately.
Okay. Now, historically, Colts fans have gotten used to having a veteran team that they play a few series in each of the preseason games, but not a lot. But this year, has it been different because of the young players and the new players, the new roles and all of that? Have they gone with the number ones and number twos maybe a little longer in some of these games than they have in past?
You know, it's been maybe a slightly different, slight difference between the previous years because before you had the veteran team, as you said. So that makes a difference, and I think that this week especially will be the last time we see a lot of number ones, and then next week we'll go to really fighting for those roster spots.
Okay, defensively, there's a new philosophy, and there are some returning players, but there's a lot of new faces as well, especially in the secondary. How's the secondary look so far this year?
Well, it's still a work in progress, I have to say.
Will that be your answer week 14 as well?
More than likely, it'll be a work in progress.
Yeah.
It depends. I mean, there's still a chance that can vastly change. The Colts will have a chance to pick up some other guys that may be released from teams. That there may be better corners out there that are, you know, the fourth guy on a more powerful team that they may be able to pick up, so that could change. Powers has looked excellent. Antoine Bethea looks tremendous. Those are the veteran guys. Tom Zbikowski has been a nice addition, and obviously he knows the Ravens style defense, which is what they're implementing. So it's better, but it's still not very deep yet.
Okay. Well, Reggie will be watching the game and writing about it Saturday evening. Check out NewsSentinel.com early Sunday morning for his thoughts on what happened and how the game played out. And thanks for your time today.